All right, graduates, in your seats, let's go. All right, eyes up here, grads. The faster y'all sit and we get through this, the faster y'all can chit-chat. All right, good morning. Congratulations. For those of you that don't know me, I'm Wesley Lejeune, the Commencement Committee Chair. I'm the one that's been sending you emails that I know you all read this semester. These are the very first spring commencement exercises we have here in the Legacy Center, so we are thrilled to have you and your guests here. Before I get down to business, I must thank the staff in the Office of the Registrar and Admissions, Office of Information Technology, Office of Marketing and Communications, University Police, and the Commencement Committee for their assistance in putting this together. However, it is the Office of Facilities and Plant Operations crew that deserves most of the credit for setting all of this up while also putting up with me. It looks amazing, so please give them a round of applause. All right, I just want to make a few announcements so you know how this is going to work and we're all on the same page. This will be a piece of cake as long as you pay attention to staff, follow the leader, and please do not make me run in this suit. You should be sitting in the seat you were assigned during check-in. If you are not, please move to that seat after I'm done with these announcements. Chad? Okay, thank you. There should have been two things on your chair when you sat down. The first is a bumper sticker provided by the McNeese Alumni Association. The second is a slip of paper with a QR code from Candid Campus Photography, our official commencement photography partner. If you have not done so already, please scan that QR code and pre-register. This will drastically reduce the turnaround time on your pictures from today. During the ceremony, your cell phone should be turned off or put on silent or do not disturb. Undergraduates, those of you in the blue gowns, you should have your cap tassel on the right until you receive your diploma, and then you will move the tassel to the left as you return to your seat. Graduate students, or those of you in the black gowns, you should have your tassel on the left throughout the entire ceremony. When we are ready for the ceremony to begin, Miss Morgan Turpin will direct you to stand. You should remain standing until Dr. Lemieux comes to the microphone and directs you to sit after the national anthem and invocation. Gentlemen, you should remove your caps during both the national anthem and invocation at the beginning and during the alma mater at the end. Again, please remove your caps during the alma mater at the end. I say it again because you will forget, as graduates do every semester. Ladies, you are not required to remove your caps at any time since they're probably stuck on your head with Gorilla Glue. or bobbin pins or whatever. When it is time for the presentation of degree candidates, Mr. Greg Bradley and Dr. Caroline Hennigan will tell each row to stand at the appropriate time. You will then line up on the east or your left side, walk up the ramp to the stage, and wait for your name to be called. You will walk from Ms. Turpin, who will be at that podium right there, to President Burkell, who will be over here. President Burkell will hand you a diploma cover and shake your hand. A photographer will be standing in front of Dr. Burkell and will take your picture at this time, so please be sure to look at the photographer. When you walk across the stage, do not throw anything. No confetti, no dollar bills. It's rained enough this week. I don't need you making it rain in here. Hey, Chad. I'm being told they can't hear me in the back. Can y'all hear me in the back now? All right. Should you feel obligated to showcase your dance moves when you go across the stage, just keep it moving, okay? Do not hold up the ceremony by staying stationary over there. Just do your little dance across the stage, okay? Please do not hold up the ceremony. To my Honors College students here in the front, this is when President Burkell will present you with your Honors College medal. If you can do so without messing up your hair for your picture, you should remove your cap so he can quickly and easily put the medal over your neck and then hand you your diploma cover. After receiving your diploma cover, you will walk to the west side of the stage, shake some hands, and then walk down the ramp where you will see Miss Susie Beasley. Miss Beasley will make a gesture that we call the windshield wiper to remind you to turn your tassel to the left. You'll then walk past Miss Beasley along the west side towards Dr. Vipin Menon, who will direct you back to your seat. We will have another photographer on the west side taking your picture as you walk back, so please don't stop walking, just look at the photographer and keep going. Once you get back to your seat, you should remain standing until everyone in your row has returned and you receive a signal to sit from Dr. Terry Simpson and Mr. Ken Baskin. At the end of the ceremony, both sides will exit out into the outside aisles, one row at a time, beginning in the front with row A. Graduates in all other rows should remain standing in front of your seat until the row in front of you has recessed out, and then you will just file out behind them. Please do not get out of line as you recess out. The diplomas are sorted based on the seating chart, so if you get out of line, you'll have to go to the back of the line. Diplomas will be distributed as you exit on the south side, so you will get your diploma and then exit the building. Students graduating with 2 degrees will receive both diplomas together as well as another diploma cover. Just a few housekeeping items. Graduates, your restrooms are located in that back hall, actually in locker rooms. Just look for the hanging signs and proceed through the locker rooms to the restrooms at the back. To our guests in the stands, your restrooms are located out in the lobby on the first floor or on the third floor over here on the east side. Also, we need to begin preparing for the next commencement ceremony immediately following this one, so please exit the building promptly at the end of the ceremony and do not congregate in front of the exits. To my guests over here on the east side, as soon as all graduates are off the floor, I will have staff open up 2 sections of the pipe and drape for you to cross the floor to the exits. Please do not take it upon yourself to separate the pipe and drape like it's Black Friday. Just be patient. As soon as all graduates are off the floor, we'll open it up so you can quickly reach the exits. Last thing, graduates, if you need to use the restroom, please do so now and be back in your seats by 8:45. Graduate students, if you need help with your hoods, please come to the front and we will have someone come assist you. If anyone has questions, just holler at me on my way to the back or catch another staff member. Thank you, and again, congratulations.
Ladies and gentlemen, the commencement ceremony is about to begin. Please silence cell phones and all other devices at this time. And now, please rise for the entrance of the stage party and faculty, led by Master of Ceremonies and Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs and Enrollment Management, Dr. Frederick Chip Lemieux.
Good morning. It is my honor to welcome you to the 160th McNeese Commencement. I am Dr. Frederick Lemieux, Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs and Enrollment Management. This morning, we celebrate the graduates in the Colleges of Agricultural Sciences, College of Liberal Arts, and the College of Science, Engineering, and Mathematics. On behalf of the faculty and staff of McNeese State University, I extend congratulations to the candidates and to their families. Please remain standing as the McNeese State University Wind Symphony, under the direction of Timothy Pardue, Director of Bands, performs our national anthem, and remain standing for the invocation. good and loving God. Thank you for the completion of another academic semester and for giving us the opportunity to educate and mentor our students and new graduates. We are thankful for your guidance and love as we shared in this important work. Please bless and guide our graduates as they reach this end and as they chart new beginnings. May what they have learned at McNeese State University allow them to be great global citizens. May our lives be enriched for having known them. Please allow them to use all that they have learned to make the world a better place, serving others in true solidarity and kinship, seeking ways to help the unfortunate and those who are suffering and always seeking the greater good. May your spirit guide them as they unfold the next chapters of their lives, and may the celebration reflect the blessings that we find in knowing and loving you. We thank you for giving us the opportunity to change lives with these young men and women. Though they are leaving our campus, we know that they will always be a part of the McNeese family, and we ask that the bonds that they have created here remain strong. For this is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice. Amen. Thank you. Please be seated. Graduates, you are why we are here today. You are why we, the administration, faculty, and staff of McNeese State University, strive every day to do our best to prepare you for the next step in your career, your continuing education, and your life. You have made an investment in your future, and today you embark on a new journey. Take pride in how far you have come. Believe in your abilities. Be optimistic about what is to come. And be thankful for your family, your friends, and your mentors. We are so proud of you, and we wish you the very best. At this time, it is my privilege to introduce Dr. Daryl Burkell, president of McNeese State University, who will deliver the president's welcome. Dr. Burkell began his term as the seventh president of McNeese on July 1st, 2017. He is a professor of accounting, and prior to becoming president, he held the Arthur Hollins Endowed Professorship in accounting. Dr. Burkell earned both his bachelor's degree in accounting and master's of business administration from McNeese. He then earned a Doctor of Business Administration from Mississippi State University. Dr. Burkell is a certified public accountant and a certified valuation analyst. He has served as president and director of the Lake Charles Harbor and Terminal District Board and chairman of the Board of Directors for Christus St. Patrick Hospital. He also served on the Board of Directors for the Louisiana Housing Corporation, the Louisiana Land Trust, and the Council for a Better Louisiana. He currently serves on the Board of Directors for J.D. Bank. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Dr. Daryl Burkell.
Thank you, Dr. Lemieux, and good morning, everyone. Welcome to our 160th McNeese State University commencement ceremony. The spring graduation class includes 703 candidates from 40 parishes, 19 states, and 17 countries. 716 degrees will be awarded today, including 33 associate's degrees, 570 bachelor's degrees, and 105 master's degrees. Many of these graduates are the first generation in their family to earn a college degree. I, too, am a first-generation college graduate, and it forever changed my life and my family's life. To the families of our graduates, I want to thank you for the love, support, and encouragement that you gave each and every one of them. Because we know that from the time that they entered, there have been many adversities that they've had to overcome. And with your help and support, they're here today. I also want to thank our faculty and staff for their commitment to excellence with a personal touch and their dedication to being student-centric in all that we do. Our mission at McNeese is to change lives. To the members of the class of 2023, your lives are forever changed because you have earned your degree. You're stronger, more confident, and resilient for your dedication and perseverance. Take pride in how far you've come and the obstacles that you've overcome. Education provides the competitive skills that sustain hope and make dreams possible. In just a few minutes, you will transition from being a McNeese student to a McNeese alumnus. The skills, passion, drive, and determination that you leave with today will make a difference in our state, our country, and our world. I remember when speaking with you over in Trinico, when we were recruiting you and you were coming here, each of you, I mentioned to you that each of you are coming here with dreams and aspirations for your life, that you had a point, that you had a vision for what you wanted in your life, and that you were coming to McNeese State University in fulfillment of those dreams. Well, here we are today. I told you that we would invest in you, that our faculty and staff would pour their lives into you and their abilities and skills into you, and that we would saw this day coming for you. And I know now you see a future for yourself, and we want you to achieve that future. Today marks a milestone for you and a day of celebration for you and your family. There'll be many other milestones in your life. Just remember, the primary ingredient for progress is optimism. The unwavering belief that something can be better is what drives us forward. Your investment in your education should give you confidence, and I encourage you to leave here today full of optimism and hope. Optimism is not wishful thinking. Optimism means that you choose to seek options and solutions when faced with challenges. There is no script for life, no textbook with all the answers. I encourage you to never stop learning, to grow in wisdom and understanding, and to always strive for excellence. In the words of Henry David Thoreau, go confidently in the direction of your dreams, live the life you have imagined. Congratulations to each of you for reaching this milestone. I wish you great success as you go forward to make a life, make a living, and make a difference in your families, your careers, and your community. At this time, it is my honor to introduce our commencement speaker. Ms. Christy Como Armand is co-founder of Healthy Image and Healthy Image Marketing Agency and Thrive Magazine. Ms. Armand has over 30 years of experience in the marketing and communications field. Ms. Armand received her Bachelor of Science degree in Mass Communication from McNeese State University in 1988. She began her career in healthcare marketing, and after 10 years in the field, she founded Healthy Image Marketing Agency in 2002. The company has grown steadily from its first client to a full-service marketing agency with four partners, 12 team members, and more than 100 clients across the country in a wide range of business sectors. Healthy Image was named one of the top 100 small businesses in the country by the U.S. Chamber of Commerce in 2013. The company was also named the 2013 Small Business of the Year by the Southwest Louisiana Economic and Development Alliance and the Small Business of the Week during National Small Business Month by the United States Congress. In 2003, Ms. Armand and her partners launched Thrive, a regional lifestyle magazine that reaches over 75,000 readers monthly. She is the recipient of numerous marketing, advertising, and publication awards. Ms. Armand was honored as one of 75 notable McNeese alumni during the 75th anniversary celebration. Christy serves on the board of several community groups, including the Chamber of Southwest Louisiana, where she was elected board chair in 2020. Recognized for her leadership, Ms. Armand was named the Women's Business Leader of the Year by the Chamber of Southwest Louisiana. In 2021, she was named the Volunteer of the Year by the Chamber of Southwest Louisiana. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Ms. Christy Armand.
Good morning. Thank you, Dr. Burkell, for that very kind introduction and for inviting me to speak today. I'm happy to be part of this celebration with you and so proud to be an alumnus of McNeese. The education I received here has provided the foundation on which I've built my life. True life lessons were learned, lifelong friendships began, and the introduction to a career I love all started right here on this campus. I work in marketing and public relations, which means you've probably never heard of me. And you may be wondering why I'm up here talking to you today. What I do is typically behind the scenes, helping others to be successful. Creating campaigns for clients and making sure you know their names, from hospitals and industrial plants to nonprofit organizations, banks, political leaders, and many others, including one very close to my heart, McNeese. We have been very fortunate to work on a variety of projects for McNeese over the years, And for me and my business partners, who are also McNeese graduates, this is always a full circle, very rewarding moment. It's also why I could not say no to Dr. Burkell when he asked me to speak today. Remember, I'm usually the one writing the speeches, not giving them, but here I am. You might be surprised to hear that this is the first McNeese graduation I've ever attended. I really did graduate from here. I have the diploma and everything, but I completed my final semester in the summer, so my commencement would have been at the end of the fall semester. By then, I was working in another part of the state, attending graduate school, and didn't want to come back for the ceremony. In my mind, I had checked college off my list and moved on. Of course, my parents wanted me to come back. Like many of you and Dr. Burkell, I was the first college graduate in my family, and they were very proud. But I was insistent, no need for the ceremony, just put my degree in the mail, please. Which brings me to the other reason I accepted the invitation to speak today. I did so to honor my dad, who passed away a few years ago. I never really understood, until many years later when I had kids of my own, how much it would have meant to him to watch me graduate. He never gave me a hard time about it, not even once. But not fulfilling that wish for him is one of the biggest regrets I have. He was always my biggest fan, and I assure you, anything there is to admire about me came from him. I imagine him laughing in heaven over the stress I've experienced over the speech this week, thinking he may have had to wait 35 years, but here I am at a McNeese graduation. My point in sharing this is to remind you that none of us got to this point, this milestone, alone. You share this achievement with your parents and everyone who has loved you, who has believed in your future, who propped you up when you wanted to give up, or told you the truth even when it wasn't easy to hear. Maybe they aren't with you anymore, and in that case, like me, you'll think of them today. If they are here, I hope you'll find your own way to express your gratitude for their role in your success. It really is such a privilege for me to recognize the graduating class of 2023. You're a very unique group. You may not even realize how rare you are. Sure, about 2 million college degrees will be awarded across the country this year, but you stand above them all. Yes, they all experienced the global pandemic and its impact on their college experience, but for you, that was just your baseline disaster. Next came not one, but two hurricanes in 2020. Category 4 Laura hit just after the campus reopened in August and devastated the region, McNeese included. I don't have to describe it. You all lived it. Just 6 weeks later, Delta rolled in. Just a Category 2. Just. I guess it's all relative, right? Delta was a major rain event dumping water on buildings that still only had tarps protecting them. Then in February of the 2021 spring semester, a different type of weather disaster struck, Winter Storm Uri. It shut down our city, freezing water lines, causing even more misery, water, and structural damage. But wait, there's more. In mid-May, as the semester was ending, historic flooding, a 100-year rain event, dropped a deluge of water on homes and buildings, many of which were still under repairs from the hurricane. That's 4 federally declared natural disasters and 1 worldwide disaster for anyone keeping score. So I think you do win when it comes to college success. During the time when most college students are trying to pick a major, when their biggest worry is making sure they have enough energy drinks and snacks for late night study sessions, you were literally learning how to survive in a third world environment. No electricity, no internet, stores and businesses closed, classrooms and housing destroyed, mandatory evacuations, the list goes on and on. But you are here. You overcame, you persevered, you did not give up. Those other graduates will be showing up to their graduation ceremonies fresh-faced and excited to finally experience the real world. But you aced that course. You deserve an extra degree in real life. I mean, you all look great. I don't see any battle wounds. But the journey to get here was obviously not an easy one. So I will spare you the usual graduation speech, full of well-intentioned advice and cautionary tales about how hard life can be, because I know you know. What I do want to talk to you about is pausing to recognize the gift these disasters truly were. Sounds a little crazy, I know, to think of pandemic, hurricane, freeze, flood as a gift, but hear me out. You've proven to yourself that no matter what obstacle or series of seemingly unending obstacles may arise, you will succeed. Not because you're immune to stress or hardship, but because you've built up a valuable skill set that helps you rise to life's challenges, resiliency. I know the word gets used a lot. It's become a catch-all term for the astonishing capacity of humans to go on in spite of disaster or tragedy they face. But as all of you have learned, resiliency is not some secret superpower. It's actually the hard-won result of all that overcoming. The good news is you are not born with a fixed amount of resilience. Like a muscle, you can build it up and draw on it when you need it. In that process, you will figure out who you really are, and you just might become the very best version of yourself. Resilience is the true gift of your very unique college experience that will serve you as well as, possibly even more than, the academic education you've received. There's a toy from my childhood, these little plastic egg-shaped figures called Weebles. You could tilt them over, knock them down, but they always return to an upright position. The commercials had a jingle, Weebles wobble, but they don't fall down. And I do think this slogan applies to you. You refuse to stay down. When life knocks you around and down, and it will again, don't think you get a pass on hardships for the rest of your life because of what you've already been through. It's very easy to get stuck in the unfairness of it all. To ask, why is this happening to me? We've all been there. And if you only look at the mountainous hurdles ahead of you, you'll stay there. But if you can look a bit farther past it, you'll see possibility instead. You remember there are positives to be grateful for, and that many things are still under your control. Your success in reaching this day, because we know not everyone who started with you did, serves as a profound reminder that feeling sorry for yourself solves absolutely nothing and never will. Harnessing the power of resilience, working to find a new way to your goal, even in the most challenging situations, is a choice, and it's one that you've obviously made. Another gift you can take from your journey is the importance of being flexible, of embracing change. Resisting change only makes it more challenging. Embracing change enables you to thrive. Of course, you would have preferred to have the normal college experience without all this disaster and drama right in the middle of it. Cheering for the Cowboys on Saturday nights in the hole, under the lights, hanging out with friends in the ranch between classes, enjoying campus life, local culture and events. You were robbed of some of that, and that's a fact. I hope you got a little bit of that normalcy back after the initial recovery was complete. But what's important is that you adapted, you overcame, and created a new normal for yourself. It was far different from what you imagined your college life would be. But what an amazing story you'll have to share in the years ahead. The fact that change is the only constant in life is one of the greatest life lessons, and you've already mastered that. Learning the importance of community is another gift you can take from your experience. I know we've all been touched in various ways by the kindness and generosity of others, particularly in those terrible dark days after Hurricane Laura. Thousands of volunteers from across the country showing up to help and bring supplies. Businesses donating and crews working to clean up and rebuild. Our community's determination to come back stronger. It was also very inspiring. It's a gift to experience firsthand the magic that can happen when people come together to work toward a common goal. You've been part of the rebuilding and reimagining of this university. We are all actively working to rebuild a better Southwest Louisiana, creating the community we want to live in. I encourage you to stay engaged and involved here or wherever your path may lead you. Let me close by repeating my advice to look at the hardships you faced in your college years as a gift, the best gift you ever survived, and survived is the key word. Key Keep that lesson close in the years ahead, and the next time you're faced with something that's unexpected, unwanted, or uncertain, approach it with the mindset that it may also have a gift to offer. Some of the biggest blessings in my life have come in the aftermath of my biggest setbacks. I've learned that challenges are what make life interesting, and overcoming them is what makes life meaningful. And what a meaningful achievement we celebrate with you today. Thank you for allowing me to share this moment with you. I can only assume many of you are now headed out to scale large mountains, win a Nobel Prize, or pick up an Olympic sport or two. You've proven that life's obstacles are no match for your determination. We expect great things from you and look forward to seeing the positive impact you have on the world. Congratulations, class of 2023.
Thank you, Ms. Orman. Dr. Wade Roos will now deliver the University Advancement Remarks.
Class of 2023, we're getting closer. You're only minutes away from receiving your diploma. Those long hours of studying for exams, writing papers, and working on research projects are behind you. Ahead lies a new world with exciting new beginnings. As you leave us, you are taking away specific knowledge in the area of your discipline, but you are also departing with lifelong relationships. Some of those were developed as lab partners, some in small groups, and yes, some relationships were established at OB's. These relationships are the foundation of your professional network. At some point down the road, whether it's during a business negotiation or simply when someone performs a reference check on you, it will be advantageous to have a McNeese network consisting of more than 45,000 proud alumni supporting you. Therefore, continue to invest and build your McNeese network. Join the McNeese Alumni Association. Attend McNeese tailgates and crawfish balls. Attend banners programs such as Rouge et Blanc, collegiate sporting events, theater productions, guest lectures, Pokes in the Oaks, and the list goes on and on and on. Throughout your life, your McNeese network will serve you well. Class of 2023, congratulations for turning your dream into a reality. We welcome you to a very proud, loyal, and global alumni family. Go Pope! Now, it is my pleasure to introduce the president of the McNeese Alumni Association, Mr. Jason Rochelle, who will announce the nominees for Outstanding Graduate Awards. Jason earned his Bachelor's of Science degree in management from McNeese in 1993, and went on to LSU to get his MBA. His wife, Heather, is also a McNeese graduate. For 25 years, he has worked in the healthcare profession. He currently serves as Chief Strategy Officer for Lake Charles Memorial Hospital. Mr. Rochelle is an active member of the community and serves on the Lake Area Industry Alliance Calcasieu Advisory Board and Southwest Louisiana Governmental Affairs and Infrastructure Committee. Please join me in welcoming Mr. Jason Rochelle.
Thank you, Dr. Roos. Today, you officially become graduates, alumni of McNeese State University. As the president of the Alumni Association Board, I am honored to announce our inaugural Outstanding Graduate Award, partnered with the Student Government Association and the Office of University Advancement. Candidates for the Outstanding Graduate Award are nominated by the dean of each college for one undergraduate and one graduate who meet an overall GPA of 3.5 or higher, actively participate in leadership and service, and emulate our motto, excellence with a personal touch. I am privileged to serve on the committee that reviewed nominees, and I have been overwhelmed by the high caliber of students we have here at McNeese. I would now like to recognize our 11 undergraduate and graduate candidates and announce our overall recipients. From the College of Agricultural Sciences, Barrett Mann, undergraduate. Kevin Trippo, graduate. From the College of Business, Madison Yates, undergraduate. Emily Whitaker, graduate. From the Burton College of Education, Micah Chavance, undergraduate. From the College of Liberal Arts, Mark Portier, undergraduate. Mariah Lee, graduate. From the College of Nursing and Health Professions, Kennedy Cooley, undergraduate. And J.C. Foltz, graduate. From the College of Science, Engineering, and Mathematics, Tulawanemi Adewobola, undergraduate. And Michael Reed, graduate. Our overall winners of the Outstanding Graduate Award are: the undergraduate goes to Micah Chavanes, Burton College of Education. And the graduate is Emily Whitaker of the College of Business. Graduates, today belongs to you. Your families and your friends. You have worked extremely hard to get to this point, and your achievements are a testament to your determination and perseverance. As you move forward to the next chapter of your lives, remember that the skills and knowledge you have gained here will serve you well. I encourage you to use them to make a positive impact in your communities and the world. I also want to thank the families and friends who have supported you throughout your academic journey. Congratulations once again, and I wish you all the success in your future endeavors.
Thank you, Dr. Roos and Mr. Schell. At this time, we'd like to recognize faculty retiring at the end of this academic year. From the College of Liberal Arts, Mr. Roderick Lauderdale, Assistant Professor in the W.A. and Dorothy Hanna Department of Performing Arts, 33 years of service. Dr. Carol Lines, Assistant Professor in the W.A. and Dorothy Hanna Department of Performing Arts, 24 years of service. And Ms. Martha Hoskins, Instructor in the Department of History, 24 years of service. Thank you for your service to our students and university. Now we will introduce our degree candidates who are honor graduates. College students make a significant commitment of time and effort to complete the curriculum required to earn a degree. While all candidates here today have met requirements for their degree, many of our undergraduate students excelled in their academic work and earned academic honors, and we will now take time to recognize them. A baccalaureate student graduates with honors by earning an overall grade point average of at least 3.5. Ms. Morgan Turpin will introduce our candidates who have earned academic honors. Honor graduates, please stand when your name is called. The following students have earned the distinction of summa cum laude for an overall grade point average of 3.9 to 4.0.
Tolowanimi Adewagbola, 4.0. Macy Maddox, 4.0. Abigail Thomas, 4.0. Colleen Fontenot. Madison Petrie. Lauren Shipp. Cade Dixon. Jacob Latham. Leon LaHaye. Carly Nunez. Jalen Jones. Haley Marso, Taha Asif, Andre Lede, Hannah Murphy, Hunter Guidry, Lauren Goodo, Emma Boyd, Lily Nguyen, Amon Khan.
The following students have earned the distinction of magna cum laude for an overall grade point average of 3.7 to 3.899.
Mia Escarino, Benjamin Rosas, Jesse Landry, Mark Hoag, Elizabeth Harlow, Megan Bonig, Ariel Harrington, Hillary Smith, Lauren Blood, Cade Manuel, Ian Anderpont, Stephanie Jones, Cannon Fontenot, Avonlea Cooper, Kia Tony, Barrett Mann, Molly Abshire, McAustin Ezenduka, Sydney Hammond, Callie Johnston, Lila LeGros, Chetta Ezenduka, Olivia Broussard, Abby Milliken, Caden Slim, Alicia Vieira Cladillo, Sujal Joshi.
The following students have earned the distinction of cum laude for their overall grade point average of 3.5 to 3.699.
Kennedy Anderson, Sarah Medwick, Trajan Chella, Ethan Bruyette, Shelby Henson, Faith Dalton, Timmy Alua Aluawadare, Ethan Cooley, Manise Gamire, Caden Burgett, Sarah Bingston, Robert Podorsky, Callie Reed, Mork Portier, Carolyn Kotacek, Griffin Turner, Landon DuPont, Deja Senegal, Terica Walter, Justin Jones, Ashton Fritz, Makia Gilry, Joseph Sanya, Alec Artigo, Jillian Pillard, Megan Davidson, Aiden Lejeune, Gracie Benoit, Jonathan Mason, Maximilian Ferguson, Rebecca Lapret, Connor Moyer, Caitlin Williams, Olivia Boudreau, Kaylee De La Cerda, Dave Achoyer, Siraj Kanal, Josette Broussard, Shay Fournier, Tanner Danos, Uchechi Adiele, Natalie Straisner, Caroline Reed, Tyron Corpus, Rita Kodka, Caleb Richard, Eulalie Cormier, Prajwal Dungana, and Ryan Abair.
Let's give these students a round of applause. Congratulations on your outstanding academic accomplishments. And now we will introduce our degree candidates. Ms. Morgan Turpin will announce the degree candidates. Out of consideration for the families and friends who wish to hear their candidates' names announced, we ask that artificial noisemakers not be used while names are announced. We will begin with our Honors College candidates. Honors College students must complete a unique curriculum in their field, which includes a minimum of 24 credit hours of honors coursework. President Burkell will present the Honors College candidates with a medallion depicting the scholarship, leadership, and service motto of the college. It is with great pleasure that I present the following McNeese Honors College candidates who have completed requirements for the baccalaureate degree with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto.
Kennedy Nicole Anderson, Bachelor of Science in Biological Science, cum laude. Thomas Hyatt Bell, Bachelor of Science in Mass Communication. Olivia Grace Boudreau, Bachelor of Science in English, cum laude. Caden Ray Burgett, 2 degrees, Bachelor of Science in Biological Science, cum laude, and Associate of General Studies in General Studies. Trajan Anders Chella, Bachelor of Science in Chemical Engineering, cum laude. Mia Jade Escarino, Bachelor of Science in Mathematical Sciences, magna cum laude. Colleen Grace Fontenot, Bachelor of Science in Agricultural Sciences, summa cum laude. Ariel Madison Harrington, Bachelor of Science in Biological Science, magna cum laude. Leon Claude LaHaye, the second. Bachelor of Science in Chemical Engineering, summa cum laude. Macy Beth Maddox, Bachelor of Science in Biological Science, summa cum laude. Alec Blake Ortego, Bachelor of Science in Biological Science, cum laude.
Dr. Thomas Shields, head of the Harold and Pearl Drip School of Agricultural Sciences, will present the candidates from the College of Agricultural Sciences.
Dr. Lemieux, the following students from the College of Agricultural Sciences have completed all requirements for graduation. The faculty of the College of Agricultural Sciences and I take great pleasure in recommending these students as candidates for the Bachelor of Science and Master of Science degrees, with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto.
From the Harold and Pearl Drip School of Agricultural Sciences with a Bachelor of Science, Molly Marie Abshire. Victoria Paige Barron. Samantha Mae Boudreau Anderson. Abigail Mills Brinkman. Olivia Claire Broussard. Hunter Brown. Maylee Beth Connor, 2 degrees. Tanner Noel Danis. Megan Paige Davidson. Madison Marie DeLosi. Jesse Nicole Donahue. Amy Catherine Dupree. Rebecca Lynn Fontenot. Shay Martin Fournier. Vanessa Rose Garcia. Caleb Matthew Gore. Dalton Kyle Gilry. Harley Ray Haley. Samantha Dale Hawkins. Miranda Marie Hoppy. Harley Brianne Jackson. Courtney Danielle LeBlanc. Aiden Lewis Lejeune. Hayden James Lejeune. Rebecca Marie LaPrette. Raven Nan Luke. Barrett James Mann, 2 degrees. Dylan Cade Manuel. Jacob Ray Matern. Aniston Lorraine Piku. Caroline Grace Reed. Madison Claire Sittig. Bailey Jordan Willis. From the William J. Dorey Senior School of Graduate Studies with a Master of Science, Bonnie Joanne McAllister. Logan Claire Richard. Kevin James Tripeau II. An Yin Vuong. Vera Joyce Wyatt Bice.
Dr. Michael Buckles, Dean of the College of Liberal Arts, will present the candidates from the College of Liberal Arts.
Dr. Lemieux, the following students from the departments within the College of Liberal Arts have completed all requirements for graduation. The faculty of the College of Liberal Arts and I take great pleasure in recommending these students as candidates for the Associate of General Studies, the Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of General Studies, Bachelor of Music, Bachelor of Science, Master of Arts, Master of Science, and the Master of Fine Arts degrees, with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto.
From the Department of English and Foreign Languages with a Bachelor of Arts, Gracie Beth Benoit. Lyndon Jean Carrier. Darian and Elise Deering. Elizabeth Jane Harlow. Anne Marie Hughes. Madison Paige Petrie. Jacob Harrison Salvador. Anna Michelle Williams. Chelsea Marie Wright. From the Department of History with a Bachelor of Arts, Lane Connor Buckles. Eulalie Marie Cormier. Brianna Renee Flemons. Morgan Elizabeth Fontenot. Amanda Ebarb Hasty. Callie Rochelle Johnston. Caleb James Richard. Natalie Renee Straysner. Kane Anthony Todd. Carson Daniel Turgeon. From the Department of Interdisciplinary Studies with an Associate of General Studies, Evan James Frugier. Jaquela Janae Fugelaire. Sean Rochelle Hebert. Reagan Brooke Knott. Valeria Abigail Lopez. Trinity Danielle Malachi. Haley Paige Meir. Bailey Simone Paradin. Grace Catherine Roussel. Raymond Charles Smith. Olivia Ray Taro. Brooke Elizabeth Thibodeau. Elizabeth Mary Ulfers. Skylar Trey Weldon. With a Bachelor of General Studies, Olafadikemi Daniela Agbalusi. Andrew Scott Anderson. Cynthia Lynn Bingston. Sydney Norris Bernard Sr. Jace Blida. Robert Crawford Boudreaux. Mackenzie Beth Bourgeois. Chandler Aaron Bork. Josette Kinesic Broussard. Holland Guy Connor. Markel Kevin Cotton. Carly Blair Crater. Deja Kalala Day. Taylor Daggett. Devon Dwayne Davis. Cade Rivers Dixon. Morgan Duck. Skylar Brooke Embry. Freddie Felice III. Abigail Ruth Fontenot. Olivia Claire Fugelaire. Cade Wayne Gardner. Lauren Trenton Goodo. Maggie May Gotro. Kylie Faye Granger. Alyssa Danae Gray. Makia DeRay Gilry. Presley Elizabeth Johnson. Lester Lee Joseph III. Quentin Cole LaRocca. Bailey Renee Lukoski. Arthur Lott IV. Elizabeth Ann Lowe. Alexis Ania Malvo. Majri Maloke Mayhew. Haley Marie Marceau. Jasa Marceau. David Arnaz Mott. Tyron Terrell McMillan. Robert Thomas Osborne. Dominique Elizabeth Perron. Sarah Pintado, 2 degrees. Sherry Elaine Rocca. Lindsay Eileen Roach. Caitlin Michelle Rogers. William Joshua Rogers. Esmeralda Ruiz Baggy. London Gail Shreve. Carly Sonye. Miranda Ray Stanley. Stephanie Lynette Stidevant. Leishane DeLachey Garden Stubblefield. Lauren Rihanna Taylor. Amy Thibodeau. Caitlin Michelle Trahan. Diem Tran. Addison Paige Barron, 2 degrees. Colin David Vincent. Mackenzie Marie Woodcock. From the Department of Mass Communication with a Bachelor of Science, Lauren Ann Beaudoin. Megan Elizabeth Bilbo. Landon Scott DuPont. Harwin Schwindy Francois. Jace Clement Granger. Jalea Marie Hackworth. Sydney Kate Hammond. Bailey Grace Keating. Carolyn Elizabeth Kotacek. Abby Lauren Milliken. Callie Ann Reed. Zachary Nathaniel Scott Jr. Madeline Noel Stark. Caitlin Elizabeth Williams. From the W.A. and Dorothy Hanna Department of Performing Arts with a Bachelor of Music, Alejandro Chapa. Jalen Devon Jones. Selassie Darrell Kennison. Jonathan James Levesque. Sarah Elizabeth Medwick. Mark Paul Portier. Madison Elaine Poussin. David Jonathan Smothers. From the Department of Social Sciences with a Bachelor of Arts, Aurora Lee Baker. Trine Lachelle Marks Blake. Callan Nicole Borrell. Stephanie Marie Lazarus. Lila Danielle Legros. Mackenzie Danielle Marks. Kayla Elizabeth Movant. Lily Love Wynn. Jillian Brene Poulard. Jordan Elise Rester. Angelica Beatriz Salazador. With a Bachelor of Science, Kayla Renee Bartlett. Trinasha Janae Conley. Breland Michael Cook. Allie K. Davis. Evelyn DeLeon. Kimberly Rose Fontenot. Ashton Tyler Fritz. Carly Lorraine Hurst. Aaron Lee Jones. Heather Renee Morrow. Jasmine Leanne Perez. Gabriel Alexander Rodriguez. Caden Joshua Slim. Terica Nevels Walter. Shirley Emmanuel Louise Williams. From the Department of Visual Arts with a Bachelor of Arts, Megan Marie Bonig. Derek Ryan Carrier. Avonlea Galen Cooper. Faith Marie Jaime Dalton. Shelby Lynn Henson. Colby Adam Quave. From the William J. Dorey Senior School of Graduate Studies with a Master of Arts, Esther Gabrielle McKinney Corville. Emily Claire Moss. With a Master of Science, Nyshalyn Antonia Brown. Sky Delaine Cormier. Seth Ferris Francis Duff. Alexia Antonia Galleon. Maria Elizabeth Lee. Mariah Elizabeth Lee. Joseph Anthony McNeely. Elizabeth Pauline Mitchell. Rochetta Sibley Ozane. Mia Catherine Rougeau. With the Master of Fine Arts, Reese Menifee. Rachel Aaron Pittman, 2 degrees.
Dr. Kathy Jackson, head of the Department of Biology, will present the candidates from the College of Science, Engineering, and Mathematics.
Dr. Lemieux, the following students from the departments within the College of Science, Engineering, and Mathematics have completed all requirements for graduation. The faculty of the College of Science, Engineering, and Mathematics and I take great pleasure in recommending these students as candidates for the Bachelor of Science, Bachelor of Science in Chemical Engineering, Bachelor of Science in Mechanical Engineering, and Master of Science degrees with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto.
From the Department of Biology with the Bachelor of Science, Taha Asif. Toluwanimi Adewagbola. Sarah Marie Bingston. Emma Marie Boyd. Kaylee Danielle De La Serna. Darian Andrea Doucette. Alexis Bray Fontenot. Cannon Jace Fontenot. Ryan Michael Abair. Aman Akbar Khan. Jesse Claire Landry. Jacob Paul Latham, 2 degrees. Andre Kenneth Lede. Obumnayake Gabriel Odenampa. Benjamin David Rosas. Elizabeth Nicole Sam. Lauren Faith Shipp. Hillary Lauren Smith. Michaela Marie Spell. Marley Ann Thibodeau. Abigail Grace Thomas. From the Department of Chemistry and Physics with the Bachelor of Science, Qasim Abdel Rauf Abu Shamat. Ethan Anthony Bruyette. Allison Claire Dozot. Jessica Levon Fall. From from the Department of Engineering and Computer Science with a Bachelor of Science. Dave Sankar Achoya. Apendra Adhikari. Uchechi Valerie Adiele. Stephen Oleke Alagbe. Hayden Chase Alston. Ian Michael Andropont. Keshav Aryal. Bryce Alexander Buller. Davis Connolly Bird. Nicholas David Como. Tyron Palma Hill Corpus. Abby Nicole DeCourcy. Ryan Russell Dennison. Prajwal Dungana. Kylie Alexandra Ezel. Cheta Vanessa Ezenduka. Maximilian T.H. Ferguson. Brady Joseph Fontenot. Mason Allen Funderburg.
Let's go, man! Who else graduated, man?
Hunter Andrew Guidry. Elijah Jasper the Fourth. Nathan Pierce Jimney. Tyler Jake Johnson. Sujal Joshi. John Quentin Julian II. Rita Kodka. Siraj Kanal. Ethan Paul Miller. Connor Wayne Joel Moyer. Carly Ann Nunez. Timilalua Alua Bosayomi Alua Dare. Nicholas James Pavelka. Maya Elise Robinson. Joseph Oladeji Sonya. David Henry Schmid. William Carson Smith. Benjamin Patrick Saunier. Adriana Paige Terrebonne. Niraj Tiwari. Ifeanyichukwu Talo Dabialua Umisie. Cody Lee Viscardis. Vikash Yadav. With a Bachelor of Science in Chemical Engineering, Joshua John Lawrence Barker. Lauren Elizabeth Blood. Ethan Wiley Cooley. Paige Lynn Dabaval. McNeese Gamire. Justin Lee Jones, 2 degrees. Majoa Naomi Kuami. Cade Michael Manuel. Victoria Bermitrica McIntyre. Hannah Victoria Murphy. Kyla Cherie Reed. Hallie Grace Reeves. Joseph Lee Slater. Olivia K. Stark. Alicia Viada Claudio. With a Bachelor of Science in Mechanical Engineering, Cameron Edward Broussard. Bradley Stephen Brzezinski. David Earl Butler Jr. McAustin Chidalu Ezinduka. Nishant Kanal Upadia. Kusal Kadiota. Cameron James May. Julian Svetoslav Monev. Enoch Alua Dunmininu Oganawa. Daylon Javon Williams. from the William J. Dorey Senior School of Graduate Studies with a Master of Science, Michaela Louise Jabush. Michael Avery Reed.
Dr. Burkell, with the authority vested in McNeese State University by the Louisiana Board of Regents and University of Louisiana System, I declare degrees conferred. Graduates, please stand. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you McNeese State University Spring 2023 graduating class. Will the graduates and audience please stand as graduate Kennedy Anderson leads us in singing our alma mater. The words for the alma mater are printed on the back of the commencement program.